Diwali, the most important festival celebrated in India, is just around the corner. I have fond childhood memories of Diwali celebrations. On the Diwali day, Appa Amma used to wake us up, me and my younger brother, early morning between 3 and 3:30. And after the ritualistic Diwali bath, the first thing that Amma used to give us was a teaspoon of the Diwali Marundu. What is Diwali Marundu? Want to know? Keep watching. Namaskarams and welcome to this Diwali special episode 1 on Munch and Mull. This festival of lights celebrates the homecoming of Lord Rama, who was exiled for 14 years. So when he returns to Ayodhya after 14 years with Sita, Lakshmana and his most favorite devotee Hanuman, Ayodhya is lit up with lamps to welcome them. Diwali also celebrates the victory of Krishna, who kills the demon Narakasura. What is Diwali Marundu and what is its significance? Diwali Marundu is nothing but a Diwali special digestive medicine. Diwali comes after rainy season and it welcomes the winter season. Winter season is also a time when people tend to indulge in oily and fatty food to combat the cold. Thus, this Diwali special digestive medicine given on the morning of the Diwali day makes it easy for the stomach to digest the various fat-rich sweets and snacks. This medicine is also taken daily during the winter months to keep our digestive system healthy. The ingredients in the digestive medicine also help to build our immunity. And it is so tasty that we as kids used to lap it up. So now let's look at the ingredients required to prepare the Diwali Legiyam. Here I have taken 3 tablespoons of chopped fresh ginger, 3 tablespoons of dry ginger powder, 1 tablespoon of coriander seeds or dhania, 1 tablespoon of ajwain seeds, 1 teaspoon of jeera or cumin, 1 teaspoon of pepper, a few pieces of cinnamon and a few pieces of long pepper. It's called tippali in Tamil and pippali in Hindi. 2 tablespoons of clarified butter or ghee, 2 tablespoons of sesame oil or til oil, 1 cup of jaggery and 2 tablespoons of honey. We will be dry roasting the spices here and grinding it along with the fresh ginger. So the quantity of jaggery should be equal to the quantity of the ground ingredients. So now let's heat the kadhai to dry roast the ingredients. Adding the dhania. Gradually start adding all the other ingredients. Ajwain, jeera, pepper, cinnamon, long pepper. Here we are not adding the dry ginger powder for roasting. The aroma of the spices is wonderful. And take care that we should not burn this. So light brown for about half a minute to 1 minute in sim flame. So we are done now. We'll switch off the gas. We'll transfer this to a mixy jar. So now let's add the fresh ginger pieces to this roasted mixture. Let's add the dry ginger powder. Let's grind this. We'll add a little water later. Add a little bit of water. Let's grind it a little more finer. Here we have 1 cup of our ground spices mix. So we've taken equal quantity of jaggery. Now let's melt the jaggery. 1 cup of jaggery. Adding a little water. now let's filter the jaggery syrup into the kadhai. Now let it just come to a boil and then we will add the ground mixture to this. It started boiling, so let's add the ground mixture. This is the ground mixture. We'll add this to the jaggery syrup. Put the flame on sim. Mix this. There should be no lumps. This needs to be heated for about 7 to 8 minutes. Gradually, we will add the ghee and the sesame oil. So, I'm adding a tablespoon of ghee. We'll gradually keep adding it. Some people sieve the ground mixture, but it's not necessary. Keep stirring it so that it doesn't get burnt. A lovely aroma is emanating. A similar preparation is given to a woman after delivering a child to heal the uterus. In Tamil, it's called Pullapetta Lehyam. Let's add the second tablespoon of ghee. I'm adding a spoon of sesame oil. Slowly starts to leave the sides of the pan. I'm adding the next tablespoon of sesame oil. Keep stirring it. Now this is done. It has left the sides of the pan. So let us switch off the gas and then add the honey. So our Diwali Lehiyam is ready. Let it absolutely cool down. So here is our Diwali Special Digestive Medicine, or also known as Diwali Legiyam in Tamil Nadu. After preparation, once it's completely cooled, you can store it in either steel containers or glass bottles. And it can be kept outside for a minimum of 15 days to 1 month. But see that you don't put wet spoons inside, otherwise it will get spoiled. Starting from the Diwali day, you can have half a teaspoon of this on empty stomach every morning, and it's suitable for all age groups. I'm sure many of you would agree to the fact that nowadays Diwali has been reduced to a mere firework display and buying new clothes. Also, many people are outsourcing the traditional sweets making. So I'm not sure whether our children are even aware of traditions like this. Isn't it worth mulling over? Traditionally, Deepavali was a celebration with lamps and less of fireworks. But in today's context, it becomes more important for people to display their wealth through how much fireworks they can burst. And as you are aware, this is leading to a tremendous pollution issues and people get respiratory disorders during Diwali season. So is it not important that we play a role in making Diwali as eco-friendly as possible? Is it not worth reviving these traditions? What other ideas do you have? Do leave them in the comment section below. And I wish you all a very happy, safe, and joyous Deepavali.